Nestled in the rolling hills about 3 miles east of downtown Oceanside rests the neighborhood of Henny Hills Estates. Built on land once owned by 20th century Olympic figure skating champion and movie star Sonia Henny, who, while never having lived in Oceanside, owned approximately 1,600 acres situated between Oceanside Boulevard on the north, Highway 78 on the south, El Camino Real on the west, and extending just past College Boulevard on the east. Over the years, the Hennys either sold off or donated the land to varied interests, including Tri-City Hospital and MiraCosta College.
Oceanside affords its local residents and...
Begun in the 1950s by Sonia's brother Leif Henny as an upscale collection of custom homes on lots of several acres, Henny Hills was envisioned as a southern extension of Bel Air, the exclusive LA neighborhood where the Hennys lived. Henny Hills today has 491 homes throughout several developments, mostly built in the 1970s and 80s. Wrapping around the El Camino Country Club, the neighborhood is characterized by wide streets lined with mature trees framing custom and semi-custom homes. In spite of its idyllic setting, however, Henny Hills had anything but a smooth start. Mary Steiger, whose husband John was the agent of record for the neighborhood, sat down with us to talk about the early days.
This was way out in the country. From this hill, you couldn't see a house in any direction. Highway 78 was there, but it was a little two-lane highway. El Camino wasn't there. It was paved up to the cemetery. The cemetery was there. Oceanside Boulevard wasn't cut through. It was a little street called Short Street, and it stopped long before it got to what El Camino is now.
Sadly, John passed away in December 2008, but the legacy of the man who helped establish Henny Hills is evident when one drives through the community.
We came out here when they had built their first model home, and it was a lovely, rambling, ranch-style home. And I remember I sat in the garage there and held open house. But I think I was about 24 years old and waited. The wind blew out here, and I'd wait for a car to pull up and buy it. It was $29,500. And you could buy a house in South Oceanside for $5,000 or $6,000, or you could have bought a house on the beach with 90 feet of frontage probably for $30,000, $35,000. So this was incredible that someone would come out this far and be willing to invest that kind of money and be out here alone. We had no bus service, no school bus service, no postal service, no telephone service. So we waited a very long time to sell that house, and finally someone came in, an orthopedic surgeon from Philadelphia.
We met up with Resident and Homeowners Association President Keith Hass to assess Henny Hills today.
And this was really the subdivision built in the whole United States at one time because of the big lots and because of the views of the ocean and the quality of life and because of the El Camino Country Club and golf and tennis. And so it was built as one of the top places to come by. And you could get that dream home for $70,000.
While dream homes for $70,000 in Southern California are a thing of the past, dream homes themselves are not. As we walked through the neighborhood, it was obvious that this wasn't just any ordinary collection of custom homes. While subdividing the lots to build more homes is not allowed, many of the original custom homes have been remodeled and expanded and display a wide range of styles and materials. On our visit, Keith introduced us to Altana and John Peach, who own one of the more modern and creative homes in the neighborhood.
We were looking at houses way down below us, and all of a sudden we looked up and saw this house and went, oh, we'd love to see that one. We enjoy being so close to the beach. It's just easy to get anywhere you want. So we can go to the opera in San Diego, or we can go to the opera in LA, or we just live a very happy life.
Maybe not so surprisingly, given its namesake, Henny Hills has always attracted colorful characters. Among the more colorful, Richard Elmore, a former Hollywood stuntman and recent guest on KOCT's Living Legacies program, and whose first film, coincidentally, was with Sonia Henny. Sadly, Richard Elmore passed away at the age of 95, just a week before the taping of this segment. So his son, Greg, spoke with us about his family's life in Henny Hills.
They used to come down to just play golf on their vacations. They enjoyed the area immensely, and when my dad turned 65 and retired, they decided to move down here, and they bought this house here.
Greg bought his parents' home for himself and his family over a decade ago, and built this granny flat on the premises. Unfortunately, Greg's mother passed away a few months before its completion, but his father lived there until his recent passing.
The weather is always beautiful here. And we get a gorgeous breeze and sunsets with the ocean view that we've enjoyed for a long time.
A lot of the people that have moved in here, even in the 70s, are still here. We do have some of the top citizens of Oceanside live in our community. We do have guests that come from cities from the south. And when they come here, they say, wow, we didn't know Oceanside had such beautiful homes and neighborhoods. So I like to show off our neighborhood to our folks from the south. We love our neighborhood. You talk to anybody. We all love where we're at.